All right, now y'all leave Beyonce alone. Leave her alone.
Leave Beyonce alone?
Yeah, y'all leave Beyonce alone.
Okay.
Center of his will.
Oh, it's funny.
Leave her alone. As long as she got something in there, that's all right. Amen. Something in there. Look at somebody and say, something in there. And it's all about being in the center of his will.
Hey. Hi, everybody. I just want to share a good word with you. And first of all, God is awesome. Mm-hmm. He has done great things for me. Mm-hmm. The scripture says in Psalms 34:1, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Okay.
In the good times and the bad times. There's a line of a song I wrote that Beyonce included in her new song, Church Girl. That says, center of thy will. That means I want to be in the will of God.
Is that what it
means?
Thanks,
Beyonce, for listening to my music, and I hope it blesses your soul.
Thanks, Beyonce? What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel. Back with another video. Now, I said I wasn't going to do any more videos on this topic, but it seems like the plot has thickened. Bishop Patrick Wooden has preached yet another message addressing Beyonce's church girl, and it seems like he's heard some of the blowback from Christians who he said in her previous video would defend the song. He even goes so far as to quote the sentence, y'all leave Beyonce alone. Now, I'm not going to overtalk this video because the bishop stands 10 toes down and he really lays it out perfectly. But y'all meet me in the comments and let me know what you think about what the bishop has to say in this video. Let's go.
This is what we're seeing. We are, and I don't know why, maybe for advantage, maybe for fortune, fame, position, acceptance, inclusion, I don't know, for praise, for relevance. We're seeing people begin to stand further and further away from biblical Christianity. Amen. Anytime you see Christians bemoaning the overturning of Roe v. Wade, anytime you see Christians who will tell you, well, I have no problem with LGBTQ plus, all that kind of stuff. That's the falling away. That's falling away. That's falling away. And this is what we've seen as we've watched believers online and elsewhere defend Beyonce. Now, let me say this to you about Beyonce. Beyonce is for whom Christ died. Jesus loves her just as much as Jesus loves you and me.
Fact.
I think she's a strikingly beautiful woman. Can sing up a storm, highly talented. But that ain't what I'm talking about. This ain't no beauty contest. We're talking about souls. We're talking about right. We're talking about wrong. You know, some guy said, well, where did you get the idea that she sold her soul to the devil? Well, her. Now, I could be wrong, but if you want to know where I got the idea, I got it from her. She's the one talking about performing and doing things, and she's summoning someone from the dead. And Shasha, this thing takes over her. Sasha Fierce takes over. She said that. I didn't say it. She's the one who talks about levitating. Do you know how much power you got to have with Satan to levitate? Where did I get it from? I got it from her. A multitude of other things. I hope she hasn't. But I tell you what, there are things that she said. So I'm taking my time because I don't. when they play it or whatever. I don't want to leave room for misspoke. And I don't want to leave room for you say for me to misspeak, and I don't want you to mishear.
Make it plain.
Now, for those believers out there, I'm not going to judge anybody's heart, but for those believers out there who defend her, she wrote in her poem, Denial. She wrote this. Now, Denial is a poem that was written, she's trying to find out whether or not her lover, husband, whomever, I don't know, is cheating on her. And she said, but still inside me coiled deep was the need to know, are you cheating? Are you cheating on me? So, and I guess it was denied. So hence the name of the poem, Denial. All right?
All right.
She said this in the poem. I crossed myself in thought. I saw the devil. I grew thickened skin on my feet. I bathed in bleach and plugged my menses monthly with the pages of the holy book. Now you Christians out there who can defend someone who have said this, defend on. But I don't believe a regular woman, she don't have to be saved. I just don't believe a regular woman, something like that would even cross your mind to do with the Bible.
Right.
No regular, she ain't got to be no church mother. You have to be saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. Don't have to be a missionary. You don't need to be capped. Amen. You don't need to be a prophetess or anything like that. Just regular.
Regular.
I don't believe that a ordinary woman, void of the Holy Spirit, she got to be spirit filled, just got her spirit. A regular person. Regular woman would use the pages of the scripture for a tampon. Now y'all say leave her alone. Do you leave that alone?
Y'all leave Beyonce alone now.
I don't know how a regular person could even imagine such. See, that's that demon stuff. Exodus, you know, that's demons. Only demons talk like that. You got to have the devil in you. But these were her words, not mine. Now, when you all have a fit on this, have a fit on her. She's the one who said it. And in this poem, she acknowledges, she calls it the holy book. I'll tell you what I'm waiting for. That will never happen. Write that about the Quran. Yeah. Say that. Say that.
That's right.
Never.
It's not going to happen.
Never.
You know why it's not going to happen? Because in Islam, they got something that we don't seem to have in Christianity. They got men. They got people with backbone who won't take something like that lying down. they'll say something. I guarantee you, you would never get a Muslim online to defend such. But Christians, oh, us.
He's talking to his own people, y'all.
We saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. See, like to me, those words don't mean what they used to. We just take anything. Do you not know that the disabled community is stronger than the Church of God of Christ? The disabled community is stronger than the modern day Christian. See, because now this happened 2 weeks ago. Beyonce's representative have confirmed the S word will be removed from heated. Earlier today, 1st of August, disability activists publicly called the singer out for using the S word. She said spaz at the end of a track. Heated is the 11th song from Beyonce's 7th solo album, Renaissance. She raps the lyrics spazzing on the on that behind.
We get it.
Spazz that, which some fans pointed out was derogatory towards disabled people, particularly the word used to apply, particularly as the word used to apply to people with cerebral palsy. A member of her team says the word, not intentionally used in a harmful way, will be replaced. The disabled community. The disabled community. But the church, all online, I'm getting instructed from sisters, praise the Lord, all these people. See, y'all mess with the wrong preacher. I'm already dead. I'm crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ who lives in me. I don't desire your approval, your friendship, your camaraderie, anything. I'm serving to him, say one day, well done. Thy good and faithful servant. Now, apart from that, I hope you get saved. Then we can, you know, we have something in common. You need to get saved, but if you don't, you're going to hell. I know y'all don't like this. So now here it is. The disabled people spoke with one voice. Now, will you tell me why the church is divided on this?
And there you have it. Another video by Bishop Patrick Wooden of North Carolina. Meet me down in the comments and let me know what you think about this video. Now, let me say this. Welcome to all the new subscribers of the channel. I appreciate all of you being a part of this community and sharing in the comments. I learned so much from your comments on previous videos, and I'm anxious to hear what you have to say about Bishop Wooden and this particular message, driving home the point, standing 10 toes down once again against the Beyonce song, Church Girl. Meet me in the comments. Let me know what you think. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation. And like I always say, y'all, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.